Hello everyone and welcome to the conference in Ketotic Hypoglycemia International. My name is Danielle and I am the Executive Director of Ketotic Hypoglycemia International, and I'm also the mother to Noah and Savannah, who suffers from idiopathic ketotic hypoglycemia.
Our journey with idiopathic ketotic hypoglycemia started in 2014, where Noah was born. Noah was admitted at the ICU for 4 weeks, where he was treated for low blood sugar. Noah was discharged after 4 weeks with spontaneous resolution. At 17 months old, he had a seizure. He had a blood sugar at 1.2 and was admitted again. 1 year later, Noah was diagnosed with idiopathic ketotic hypoglycemia. After 17 months of constantly nursing, Savannah was diagnosed too. And in the end, my wife, Danielle, was also diagnosed with idiopathic ketotic hypoglycemia.
The day we were going to present, Noah had a severe incident with ketotic hypoglycemia in the morning. He was picked up by the paramedics and he was admitted at the same hospital we were going to present at.
I'm Henrik Tybo Christensen. I'm a professor in pediatric endocrinology at the Hans Christian Andersen Children's Hospital in Odense, Denmark. I've been working with hypoglycemia as my special field of interest for more than 15 years. I once was at a meeting to present something about ketotic hypoglycemia. And I had invited Daniel because I know from another family organization that families are a resource also for us professionals. It's important to get the impressions and the stories told by the families. This can make us focus better on where we should research.
So at the end of the afternoon, we were going to present and Noah was just discharged from the hospital and he was going to watch me present at this pediatric meeting. Henrik came to the hospital, the professor, and he said hi to Noah and Savannah, my daughter, who were playing in the hall.
We started up with the idea that ketotic hypoglycemia is more than normal variation. It's long been considered as a normal variation in small children, but it is more than that. And very little research has been done to go deeper into these more severe affected persons. Maybe it's because that ketotic hypoglycemia lies somewhere in between endocrinology and metabolism, and these experts from these fields need to be gathered before we can really move on. And very quickly, Ketotic Hypoglycemia International have made experts from the two fields of endocrinology and metabolism get together and start working together and producing research and papers to get more knowledge spread about ketotic hypoglycemia.
After my presentation, Henrik took the stage. Noah came into the room and I realized something was so very wrong. He was shaky, he was pale, and what was thought to be a presentation about what ketotic hypoglycemia is suddenly turned out to be a live demonstration for the audience to see how to handle an emergency situation. Thanks to Henrik's guidance, we were able to stabilize Noah in front of the whole audience.
I felt that when Danielle presented her story and the family story, it made a big impression to the audience, perhaps stronger than my more boring PowerPoint slides. In our team, we've found new genetic causes to unexplained or idiopathic ketotic hypoglycemia. But this is just a little contribution. Much more has to be done. I have the clear impression that the family organization helps a lot of families around the world who feel that their children and their family have not been taken serious enough because of this widespread impression that ketotic hypoglycemia is just normal variation that doesn't need to be done much about. But these families, I'm sure, have benefited from this organization. And in the future, we will learn more about genetic explanations. We will also learn more about ketotic hypoglycemia in chronic malnutrition, undernutrition, chronic infectious diseases, where the children get caught in a vicious circle because the ketone bodies makes them vomit and have nausea, and so they cannot eat and get into a better nutritional status. The textbooks must be rewritten about ketotic hypoglycemia, and in 10 years I'm sure that the family organization has helped with a contribution to a new approach to ketotic hypoglycemia, more knowledge about diagnosing and treating ketotic hypoglycemia. So I look forward to further collaboration in future with this organization, and I look forward to the symposia where we will meet.
1 year ago, when we started this organization, we were just me and my brother. Today, we are almost 900 families united from all over the world. We are fighting to unite the patients, the physicians, and the experts towards an enhanced understanding of idiopathic ketotic hypoglycemia, sometimes being more than normal variation of childhood.